This is Margaret and welcome to my YouTube channel Grammar Buzz, Learning Made Easy. Cool! Hey, thanks for joining me today. In this video, we are going to learn about capitalization. Capitalization, so much fun. Hey, can you say that with me? Capitalization. Whoa, what a long word, capitalization. But first, we want to know about the lesson objectives. So, our lesson objective today aims at helping us to know what is capitalization and when do we use capital letters, right? So, capitalization, eh? What's up with capitalization? What is capitalization and how do we use them? Great questions though, so let's find out. Well, capitalization is simple. It's just using capital letters. Yes, that's what capitalization means. Use of capital letters. So you see, here is a capital letter A. Most of the letters we use when we write are lowercase letters though, like this lowercase letter A. But there are special times when we use capital letters or uppercase letters. Every letter has two ways when written, as capital or uppercase letter and as small or lowercase letter. Now I guess you already know the two forms in which letters are written, as capital letters and as lowercase letters. Yes, but you know what? Now it's time for us to know another important question, and that is, when do we use capital letters? That's a very important question, you see. When do we use capital letters? Hey, did you know we had rules for capitalization? The capitalization rules? Yes, capitalization means using capital letters. So we are going to learn about some of the important capitalization rules so that you can know when to capitalize letters and when to leave them lowercase. And here we go with the first capitalization rule, and that states, always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. Always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. Well, let us look at this example. Okay, and here's the picture of a tricycle, and a sentence says, the tricycle is red. The tricycle is red. Now notice the T of the, yes, it is capitalized. That's because we always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. So remember, we always, always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. How about this one? We enjoyed the ride. We enjoyed the ride. Notice the W? Yes, it is capitalized as well. That's because it's the first letter in a sentence. And we always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. That's our first rule for capitalization. So, the first capitalization rule, as you already know, is always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. And our second capitalization rule says, always capitalize names and proper nouns. Yes, always capitalize names and proper nouns. Well, let us look at the examples. Take a look at this picture. It's a picture of Taj Mahal. And a sentence states, the Taj Mahal is magnificent. The Taj Mahal is magnificent. The T of the is capitalized. You know why? Yes, of course you do. Because we always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. But note the T of Taj Mahal is capitalized as well. And that's because Taj Mahal is the name and it's also a proper noun. And you know what? We always capitalize names and proper nouns. That's our second rule of capitalization. Well, take this sentence into account. I think Coco is asleep. I think Coco is asleep. In this sentence, I is capitalized because it is the first letter in a sentence, and the C of Coco is capitalized as well Because Coco is the name of this cat. It's a name. Yes, you remember? We always capitalize names and proper nouns. Coco is the name, and in this case, it's a proper noun too, because it's a special name of this cat. So, remember that. Always capitalize names and proper nouns. Well, what about this one? It states, the Ganges is a big river. The Ganges is a big river. Well, the T of the is capitalized. You already know why. Because it's the first letter of the sentence. And the G of Ganges is capitalized because it's a special name of a river. It's a proper noun. You see? So remember, always capitalize names and proper nouns. Names of countries, rivers and mountains are always capitalized. They are names and they are proper nouns. So remember, we always capitalize names and proper nouns. Hey, here's something interesting for you. Did you know, when used as names, the words mom, dad, grandma and grandpa are capitalized even though they are not proper nouns? Yes, it's really interesting, you see. When the words mom, dad, grandma and grandpa are used in a sentence as names, they are capitalized even though they are not proper nouns. That's because they are used as names in sentences. Okay. Well, let us take this sentence into account. It says, I love playing with mom. I love playing with mom. The I of the sentence is capitalized because it begins the sentence. That's the first rule. We always capitalize the first letter of sentences. And the M of mom is capitalized because mom is used as a name in this sentence. This is what the child calls her. She calls her by the name of mom. So mom is used as a name in this sentence and the M is capitalized. Remember, we always capitalize names. Well, take this sentence into account, and that is, fishing with grandpa is fun. Fishing with grandpa is fun. The F of fishing is capitalized. Well, because it is the first letter of the sentence. And the G of grandpa is capitalized as grandpa is used as a name in this sentence. Remember, we always capitalize names. Yes, that's the reason why. I bet you will remember this. So, the capitalization rules again. Always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. Always capitalize names and proper nouns. And a third rule states, always capitalize days, months and holidays. Yes, always capitalize days, months and holidays. And that's our third rule. So let's take this sentence into account. It states, my birthday is on Sunday. My birthday is on Sunday. Hey, the M of my is capitalized. Can you tell me why? Yes, of course. Because it's the first letter in a sentence. And the S of Sunday is capitalized as well. Because we always capitalize days, months and holidays. And Sunday is the name of a day. Whoa, look at this one. I love when it snows in December. I love when it snows in December. The I is capitalized because it begins the sentence. And the D of December is capitalized because we always capitalize days, months and holidays. And December is the name of a month. So remember, we always capitalize days, months and holidays. Well, look at this one. We decorate our house for Christmas. We decorate our house for Christmas. You see, the W is capitalized because it begins the sentence. And the C for Christmas is capitalized as well because Christmas here is the name of a holiday. And we always capitalize days, months and holidays. That's right. We always capitalize days, months and holidays. I guess you have quite understood this rule. So let's move on with the capitalization rules. Always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. Always capitalize names and proper nouns. Always capitalize days, months and holidays. And here comes in a fourth rule. It states, always capitalize names of books, newspapers and magazines. Is it? Yes, of course. Always capitalize names of books, newspapers and magazines. Let's take this sentence into account. I have read Gulliver's Travels. I have read Gulliver's Travels. The I is capitalized because it begins the sentence, and the G of Gulliver's is capitalized as well, together with the T of Travels, because it's the name of a book. So remember, we always capitalize names of books, newspapers and magazines. That's right. So here comes in our capitalization rules again. Always capitalize the first letter in a sentence. Always capitalize names and proper nouns. Always capitalize days, months and holidays. Always capitalize names of books, newspapers and magazines. And what about our fifth rule? Yes, our fifth rule states, always capitalize names of subjects and languages. Yes, always capitalize names of subjects and languages. Well, let us take this sentence into account. I find mathematics difficult. I find mathematics difficult. Yes, the I is capitalized because it begins the sentence, and the M of mathematics is capitalized because we always capitalize name of subjects, and mathematics is the name of a subject, you see. I guess you have quite understood that. And moving on with our next example, it states, Robert can speak good French. Robert can speak good French. The R of Robert is capitalized because it begins the sentence and it is also a proper noun and a name. And the F of French is capitalized because it is a language, it's the name of a language, and we always capitalize names of languages, right? Yes, that's it. So, the capitalization rule states, always capitalize the first letter in a sentence, always capitalize names and proper nouns, always capitalize days, months and holidays, always capitalize names of books, newspapers and magazines, always capitalize names of subjects and languages. And here comes in our next important rule, and that states, always capitalize titles like Dr., Mr., Mrs. and Miss. Yes, always capitalize titles like Dr., Mr., Mrs. and Miss. Okay, let's have a look at this one. This rule that we are looking into has many rules plus a bonus rule for I. So let us read out the sentence aloud, and that is, last Friday I met Mr. Berry at the mall. Last Friday I met Mr. Berry at the mall. Well, the L of last is capitalized because it begins the sentence. That's with our first rule. Always capitalize the first letter in our sentence. The F of Friday is capitalized because Friday is the name of a day. And we always capitalize days, months and holidays, remember? The M of Mr. is capitalized as well, because we always capitalize titles like Dr., Mr., Mrs. and Miss. So that's our new rule, you know. The titles are always capitalized, and Mr. is the title of this man, Mr. Berry, you see. The B of Berry is capitalized as well, because it's a name and it's a proper noun. It's the name of a person. It's a special name, you see. So we have capitalized B. And now with our bonus rule, although it's not a rule, but it's good to remember. You see, we have also capitalized the I in this sentence. That's because we always capitalize I when it appears alone or all by itself in a sentence. Remember that. It's not a rule, but it's good to remember. We always capitalize I when it appears all by itself in a sentence. So, hey, do not forget the capitalization rules. So let's hear them out one last time. And that is, always capitalize the first letter in a sentence, always capitalize names and proper nouns, always capitalize days, months and holidays, always capitalize names of books, newspapers and magazines, always capitalize names of subjects and languages, always capitalize titles like Dr., Mr., Mrs. and Miss, and always capitalize I when it stands all by itself. Yes, and you did it! Yay, you did it! And it's time for the capitalization game. So let's begin. You know what? I will be showing you a sentence and you will have to capitalize wherever necessary. So are you ready? I bet you are. So let's get going. And this is our first sentence. Baking pie is easy. Baking pie is easy. Hey, so what do you think about this one? Where shall you capitalize? And you are absolutely right. It is B of baking because the B starts the sentence. Good job. And here we move on with the next one. It states, I have a dream of climbing Mount Everest. I have a dream of climbing Mount Everest. So, where will you capitalize? Whoa, I think you have already got that, have you? You are a smart one, I know that. Come on, let's check our answers together. And that is I, because it begins the sentence. M of Mount, because that's the title. And E of Everest. Well done! Mount Everest, that's the name, that's a proper noun. Great job! You've done a great job. Okay, moving on with our next sentence. And that states, we are taking Grandma to the airport. We are taking Grandma to the airport. Hey, where are we supposed to capitalize? Have you got that? I think you have. So let's check together. It's the W as it starts the sentence. And it's the G of Grandma because that's the name. That's the name by which we call her. So we capitalize the G. Good job. Here comes the next sentence for you. And it states, Mrs. Lata has worked hard all Diwali. Mrs. Lata has worked hard all Diwali. Hey, where will you capitalize? Have you spotted them all right? Yes, it's them, more than one. I guess you have. So let's check. It's M as it's the title and it's also the beginning of a sentence. The L of Lata, that's the proper noun or the name. And the D of Diwali, yes, because that's the holiday, name of the holiday. Mrs. Lata has worked hard all Diwali. Good job. And here comes the last one for you. Have you read the Ramayana in English? Have you read the Ramayana in English? So, where will you capitalize? Have you got that? I guess you have. Okay, so let's check together. It's the H as it begins the sentence. The R of Ramayana, as that's the name of a book here. And E of English, because that's the language. Good job. Well done. Hey, that was a fantastic job that you did. Hope this video helped you understand the use of capitalization. If you have any questions at all, you know what to do? Just pop them in the comment box and I will get back to you for sure. Hey, thanks for watching this video and staying with me for so long. Don't forget to like, comment, share, press the bell icon and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. This is Margaret signing off for today. Take care of yourself and bye.